Sometimes I like just to stay on the top of the first dune, looking the people's reaction. People arrive and...
The first time that I came here,
I was around 12 years old.
It was shocking.
It was a feeling like to be in another planet. It looks like a desert, but Lençóis Maranhenses gets more rain than Scotland or London, which is around 1,600 millimeters a year. So it's not a desert, it's something else.
Lençóis Maranhenses, on the northeast coast of Brazil, sits at the intersection of three biomes, a rare overlap that supercharges biodiversity. Here, a field of dunes spreads across 350 square miles, and every year these mountains of sand migrate up to 80 feet. Then, during the rainy season, thousands of lagoons appear, many big enough to swim in. So what makes this surreal environment possible? And why, even after 2 million years in existence, does it still feel so mysterious?
Lençóis Maranhenses is the biggest field of dunes in South America.
Between these dunes, during the rainy season, the water level rises and they form lagoons.
You can never see Lençóis Maranhenses twice because everything is changing all the time. Strong movements of sand and water changing the shapes and the composition of the lagoons. I spent almost like a year camping and living in tents around the park and surveying amphibians and reptiles. This opportunity changed my view of life and helped to forge the biologist that I am today.
Some visitors arrive there and wonder why the water just doesn't sink.
Underneath the field of dunes, there is a rock which traps water, so it doesn't keep sinking forever.
So let's imagine there is a bathtub. When it rains, the water level starts to rise.
And then you can see the water in the holes in between the dunes, so you can see the lagoons formed.
And then in the dry season, the water evaporates, the water level starts to go down again. Until it gets here, the water is still there. People cannot see it, but it's still there.
Se esse ano a lagoa for em um local, no próximo ano a gente já sabe que a lagoa não vai ser mais ali. Porque onde a lagoa chega, a duna é terra, aquela lagoa, e ela já vai surgir mais na frente um pouquinho.
Here, an unusually large tide range creates a wide beach at low tide. Strong winds lift the fine sand and blow it inland to build new dune ridges.
The winds come mainly from the same direction. The sand gets dry and then they can be carried by the strong winds. They measure the size of the grains. It's so little.
The sand is so soft, so loose, that it flows down the hill like water. It's beautiful.
The wind is constantly redrawing paths, so locals follow wind and ridgelines, not maps.
Nasci e me criei aqui na Ponta do Mangue. Meus pais nasceram aqui, meus avós nasceram aqui, e a gente vive aqui todo o tempo.
Às vezes a gente vai de manhã, tá ventando, a duna tá reta. Quando a gente volta à tarde, se movimenta, a duna já tá de outra forma. Tem que ter bastante atenção, porque às vezes a gente se perde. Do nada venta e apaga todo o rastro de carro. Do nada ela cria uma duna no meio da outra. Tem uma semana, do nada a gente pegou a duna errada e fomos embora. Mas na frente a gente percebeu que a gente não tá no caminho correto. Voltamos de novo, fomos atrás do caminho pra poder vir. Chamo do deserto que respira por causa das dunas, né? O movimento das dunas.
everything is destroyed and rebuilt every single year.
In the region of Lençóis, everything is mixed. There are some animals that perish just there, and salt marshes, very far from the ocean. Different from almost all the others that exist in the world. That usually occur very close to the beach because it needs this salt.
We have a turtle, which is Pininga, water tiger turtle. So it's an endemic species, and the park plays an important role for its conservation because it doesn't exist anywhere else. And this animal is known to rest digging underneath the dunes. So it reduces its metabolism, waiting for the next rainy season.
The fish have a life cycle shorter than 1 year. They leave the eggs that are resistant to this dryness, and when the water comes, everything comes to life again.
We are going to a world of extremes. Lençóis, it's a micro laboratory. As we increase our knowledge, we might find ideas that might be useful on the perspective of climatic emergency.
Como nós mora próximo das dunas, com o tempo a gente tem que mudar. Meu pai morava no meio daquelas dunas, ó. A duna vem crescendo, vai aumentando, aumentando. Aqui pra gente mesmo, daqui uns 3, 4 anos, eu acho que tem que sair daqui. Porque a duna vai chegando perto e vai jogando areia. Quando as lagoas secam, a gente pega os peixinhos daquelas lagoas que estão secando e coloca onde tem mais água, para eles ficarem sobrevivendo, porque senão eles vão morrer de seco, que seca tudo.
When I close my eyes and I think about Lençóis Maranhenses, the first thing that comes to my mind is a dragonfly flying over a lagoon. There are white flowers. They are roots dancing in the water. It's a place that can really change people's mind and soul and hearts. And they say, for the first time I'm breathing. Very special place, master.
When I passed away, I liked it to burn me and put my ashes moving from lakes to lakes. Moving with the wind, with the water. To be part of it forever.
Hi, we want to hear your feedback. Every year, PBS Digital Studios sends out an audience survey, which we use to help understand what you enjoy on YouTube and what you would want to see us make more of. You also get to vote on new show ideas, so it would be great if Untold Earth fans were well represented in the polls. There's a link in the description. Thanks in advance.